Namaste everyone and greetings to all. I am Vatsal Parekh. Isn't it ironic, yet so good, that we are staying at home on the Independence Day? Jokes apart, I am here to unveil my thoughts on the topic, we will make India self-reliant. During this lockdown, which has lasted for way longer than we expected, our Prime Minister has launched a campaign named Self-Reliant India, or as we commonly say, Atmanirbhar Bharat. Under this program, Indian consumers are made to retrospect their purchases and are appealed to use Indian products instead of foreign goods. The core reason of this program is to decrease the dependency of foreign goods and to start producing in India itself. Majority of household Indian products has a Chinese share in it, just because of its lower cost and higher leverage of money. A study reveals that almost 8 out of 10 Indian household product has a Chinese share in it, either directly or indirectly. So how can we decrease this dependency without producing adequately in India itself? Nevertheless, the great industrialists, be it Tata, Birla, Ambani or Mahindra, has pledged to use Indian raw materials instead of foreign, even at the cost of higher amount. This should be the mindset of the people by making a purchase. No matter how high the cost is, Indians should switch to Indian products, because the satisfaction of using Indian products is purely a compensation to the higher amount spent on it. Not only will it increase the national income of the country, but will it also increase the opportunities of employment in India. The local traders in India will be encouraged to expand their businesses. Every coin has two sides. Let's talk about the consequences of banning foreign goods in India. India is a large exporter of agricultural and pharmaceutical product in foreign market. By banning foreign products in India, India will have to face severe repercussions of Indian goods being banned in foreign. And because of this, India will have to face severe losses. The best solution I can think of is that Indian industrialists should be appealed to maximize their production. Indian intelligence should be appealed to increase their performance and to make India a technological giant. Indian brains are the best, and we know that, and this has been proved efficiently by Indian CEOs leading the greatest company on the globe. All we need to do is channelize this brain power and to leverage maximum advantage from it. On a concluding note, I would like to add a befitting quote that says, "The power of togetherness is the greatest power of all." I cannot agree more with this quote, as it states the unity, the core value of India. By being united, Indian consumers can ban Chinese product or any foreign product and accept Indian product on a large scale, making this scheme a great success. And by this, Indians can turn this crisis into opportunities, or as we can say, aapda ko avsar mein badalna. Thank you.